Hello, so good morning. It's our module week 5 na. Ayan. So week 5 na tayo. Now we'll discussing only day 1 and day 2. So for our start, so meron tayo dito na what is new. Yeah. So your task is to answer it in essay form. Answer the question, what is the importance to set your own computer setup? Wow. Ano yung importansya, bakit kailangan mo i-set up yung sarili mong computer? In your own preference nga, tinatawag. Why should be final appearance of your design must be presentable and pleasing to your prospective customer? Ba't kailangan presentable ang ginawa mo? Hindi yung hindi yung parang basta-basta na lang, kailangan maganda. Bakit kailangan presentable siya sa customer? What is the purpose of that? No, so yun lang. And then after that, you have your task to answer it in multiple choice. Yeah, so A, B, C, D. Yan. Okay, the topic is about limit commands. So nadito po yun, yeah, sa topic na to. So you will read this to order to answer this. No, yeah. Okay. So now let's go to our day 2, the main course of our lesson. So that's only the pre-test and Ayan. So our lesson is about limit command. So what is limit command? Limit command is a set of visible drawing boundary in drawing area. So the word itself, limit, and it's defined as boundary. So ibig sabihin, binibigyan natin ng boundary yung pagdodrawingan natin. Ang interface kasi ni AutoCAD ay napakalawak. Kaya nga nitong gumawa ng isang floor plan ng buong isang city, kahit nga buong mundo, ganun kalawak yung boundary, space ni AutoCAD. Ngayon, kung gusto mo lang magkaroon ng boundary, halimbawa, nililimit mo yung sarili mo for doors, halimbawa, meron kayong project na bungalow house. Tapos yung lupa niya may ganun lang kalaki. So ililimit mo lang 'yon. Lalagyan mo siya ng limit. Bakit may limit? Para pag lumampas yung drawing mo, hindi siya sasagad doon or hindi siya lalampas doon sa limit na 'yon. 'Yon. So nalilimitahan yung laki ng drawing. So yun lang, that's the main purpose of the limit command, para hindi lang lumampas. Another purpose of limit command is, for example, nagdi-design ka sa gitna ng isang drawing. Halimbawa, nakagawa na kayo ng floor plan, di ba? Nakagawa na kayo ng interior design ng bahay. Tapos meron kang gagawin doon sa may gitna ng bahay. Ngayon, para hindi magalaw yung ibang drawing, maglalagay ka ng parang boundary, limit, na hanggang doon lang yung drawing. Pag lumampas, yeah, pag lumampas yung drawing mo, hindi maapektuhan yung iba. So hindi siya lalampas. The literal word is, pag nag-draw ka ng line doon, hindi lalampas yung line mo doon sa boundary. So yun, kaya tinawag siya na limit command. So when you type in the limit command in your command prompt, you just type in LIM, send, then enter. So lalabas yung limit command line bar. So sa limit line bar, there are some list of prompts. The following prompts are: lower left corner, specify the lower corner of the drawing limit. Dito pwedeng gamitin yung coordinate system. You can type in the x, y, the negative y, ganyan. So yan. Or you just simply type in what is the limit that you needed. Halimbawa, type 10, then you go to the upper corner. Then type 10 again. So, para magkaroon ng limit na 10, 10 is to 10. Or 10 meters by 10 meter. So, ganun lang po yun. The lower corner, specify the lower corner of the drawing limit. Yun yung, asa ba yun? Yun, yung lower limit. Ito yun. Tapos, yung upper right corner, specify the point of drawing area represent the opposite corner. So yun yung i-represent niya, the opposite corner. Yeah. So on turns the limit checking when the limit's checking on the cannot enter the points of the outside of the grid. So pag naka-on siya, syempre hindi ka makakalampas doon sa limit ng grid. And pag naka-off naman siya, syempre pwede ka na lumampas. So nawaw tendency is na doon pa rin si limit ng line pero pwede ka na lumampas. So ganun lang 'yan. So how what is the step on how to limit the model space? First, you need to type in on the interface or click the right, like click on the interface and type in limits or just type simple three letters, L-I-M. Type L-I-M. Then you can, after type in, enter or space bar to prompt the command. Yan. Then number three, specify the lower corner. So, unang lalabas doon, ito yung cursor niya. Tapos, unang lalabas, meron dalawang digit number. Yung first digit number, it type 0 for X or Y. Then, pagtapos na kayong i-type in yung first specify corner nyo, type in comma para naman siya lumipat doon sa kabila. Pag nag-type na kayo ng comma, magla-lock na yon. Magla-lock na yung first specification So, yung first specification location mo, tapos, pupunta na siya kay Y. Tapos, yun, bibigay mo yung command. So, dito, tapos, pag naibigay mo na yung, ano, two numerical specification command mo, type mo na yung enter para ma, ano, end of the, ano, yung command. Enter or spacebar. Then, specify the upper corner. Yan. So, dito na yung limit command, no? Nabigay mo na yung limit. So, kailangan mo naman ngayon specify yung upper right corner. So, pwede nyo i-stretch yan, yan. So, from that origin, stretch nyo lang doon sa upper corner. Yan. So, ganun lang po yun. Then, pag na-stretch nyo na, doon sa specify corner, ayan, diba, imaginary boundary, lalabas yung imaginary boundary, ano yan. Tapos, type in, enter. So, lalabas dito, the green spacing of XY spacing is 1 meter by 1 meter. Yeah, so, it's equivalent of the, no, kaya yan 10 by 10. Nasa scaling kasi yan. Yeah. The result model space view after zoom all command. So, makikita natin, pag sinoom all natin, makikita natin yung buong space niya. Kung ano yung nasakupan niya. So, makikita natin dito, no? We will distinguish this by logical. Ang nakalagay dito is 10 by 10, no? 10 by 10. So, yung grid X spacing natin is 10 and the Y grid spacing natin is 10. So, lagay natin dito, bibilangin natin yung box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So, 10 siya. Then, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10. 10, 10. So, yun na po yun. Yun po yung ano. So, ibig sabihin, lahat po nang nasa loob ng, ano, ng blue line na ito, itong limit line na to, doon lang tayo pwede mag-drawing. Pero, in beyond that, yung lampas po niyan, hindi na tayo makakapag-draw. Hindi nagagana yung mga tools natin or mga line natin sa lampas niyo. So, naka-limit na po siya. So, ganun po yung idea ng limit command. And that's our lesson. Now, let's go to our activity. Here, meron tayo dito, study ng model space below. Yan. Parang pagkakaparehas nito. Parang may pagkakaparehas. Okay. And, supply the missing information to complete the limit commands. Write your answer space below. So, saan raw kukunin ang sagot nito? Ay, nako. Minsan, hindi ko alam bakit hindi pa nakikita ng bata pero parang ito lang siya no. Parang ito lang siya. Parang yan lang 'yon no. Parang ililipat lang dito no, 'di ba? Okay. So 'yun po yung kailangan yung gawin. Okay. Now let's go here. Yan. So dito, ang gagawin natin dito ibibigay natin yung tag dito. Ibibigay natin, ay, hindi, ito yung direction. Study the model space, list the lower left and upper right corner points in each established limits. Write your answer on the space provided. Ngayon, dito, ibibigay raw natin yung lower left and upper right corner points ng bawat square na to. Ayan. So, Ayan. So, ito yung ating tawag dito. Ito yung ating square. Yan, for example, nga palang example. Yan. So, para hindi ko na ibigay yung sagot, gumawa ako ng example para magaya niya. Isod ko lang to. Yan. Ayaw niya doon. Ayan. Okay, yan. Pwede na yan. So, dito tayo sa number 1. Sa number 1, nakikita natin ang origin natin dito sa 1. Kung kailangan raw natin makuha itong lower corner and upper corner na to. So, the one technique is to count the boxes. Yun lang naman yung the main idea, no? Magka-count tayo from the boxes. Okay, from the lower left, yeah, lower left na, tama ito. Lower left corner, count tayo ng box. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 siya. Then, yung upper corner, going up naman tayo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, so, 6. Tapos, ang origin mo is 0 dito. Yan. So, 6 by 6. No? Yan, ganun lang. 6 by 6. Tapos, ito naman. Or lower origin natin, bilang tayo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Ay, sorry. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15. Naduling ako doon. Isa pa. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So, 16 dito sa baba. Sa upper row, ano, corner tayo. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12. So, 6 and 12. Ganun lang po yan. Now, doon tayo sa number 3. Ah, number 2 pala to. Okay, doon tayo sa number 3. Okay, count tayo sa lower left. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So, 24. Tapos pataas naman tayo para sa upper corner. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Yan. So, ganun lang po kasimple pagsasagot ng ating limits. Ano. Okay? Limits command. So, ganun lang. That is your activity for today. So, that is for day 1 and day 2 activity. Okay, because in day 3, ibang lesson na po yan. So, I will discuss that by tomorrow. Okay? So, this is the unit command naman. This is how to change your units. So, simple lang yung command. So, that's all for today. And thank you for listening. Bye-bye.